now. Carter.
Sure. I mean, what we know, and while mean reversion is not always a good technique, quite often it's right to stick with momentum. When something gets stretched too far, it's usually right to take the road less traveled. People love tech, and of course, now they hate it. They loved energy, and guess what happened? It just dropped 22% in a matter of sessions, and now all of a sudden, no one wants to talk about it. It registered something that it had never done on the 1st of June, and it's all sort of playing out. Let's look at a few tables and figure it out together. The first, just what do we know? The right column is the thing to focus on. It's the spread over the last 5 years, so-called how much energy has under or outperformed the S&P. And of course, you see year to date how big that is versus, let's say, 2020. It's almost the equal and opposite. Next, let's look at the first chart. This is the S&P 500 energy sector. It is as well-defined a channel, two parallel lines as you can have. Energy touched the top of the channel to the penny and failed like literally something falling out of the air. And yet, all the while, was loved until just hours ago. Let's keep going. The next thing is the most important of all. This is a ratio. A ratio chart is, well, you're not looking at the security itself, a security. It's simply one thing divided by other. It's one of the most basic things in markets, and it depicts relative performance. This is simply S&P 500 energy divided by the S&P. And what we had on the 1st of June was the most extreme reading ever in the history of the data. In fact, more extreme than energy's peak in 08. And so the final chart looks at just that. How far above trend were we? We were some 40% above the 150 million average. That is even higher than tech's relative strength line was at its peak in 2000. Everybody loves it. And now all of a sudden, the love has disappeared.